Bennet from Paul Bennet Air Shows. Completes his takeoff sequence. Paul's going to climb to a height around 5,000 feet. We'll wait for the smoke to come and that'll signal the start of Paul's display. Now, Paul is a man that needs no introduction. He's one of the show's premier aerobatic airshow performers and has over 7,000 hours of aerobatic flight time. And in 2009 was crowned the Australian Unlimited Aerobatic Champion, receiving the Phillips Cup Trophy. And in 2016, we won the Australian Freestyle Aerobatic Championships. As Paul climbs to height, he'll be checking his engine temps and pressures, as well as his five-point harness. He'll reposition himself into the wind. We'll wait for the smoker to come on, and that'll signal the start of Paul's display. German Hyde Air Show, right, spiraling down. Paul's going to reach speeds of over 400 kilometres an hour. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the beautiful blue skies over Illawarra and Shell Harbour. Paul Bennet and the Wolf Pits Pro. Show left as Paul goes vertical again, he'll do a half roll right, followed by 1.5 vertical rolls left. Rolling over the top, he'll be setting up for the inside diving snap rolls. As Paul pulls to the 45, he'll do a full roll right, followed by 1.5 flick rolls to the left, stopping in vertical. Paul's going to attempt a full forward flip in the Wolf Pits Pro. Now pushing forward on the stick, Paul's actually experiencing up to 6 times the force of negative G's. That's 6 times the force of gravity as Paul tries to throw Paul from the cockpit. Pulling vertical again, finishing the shoulder roll. He's going to point the Wolf Pits Pro perfectly vertical. At the top of the vertical, he's going to put in hard left rudder and turn around not once, but twice. The Wolf Pits Pro was custom built and weighs in at barely 600 kilograms. However, it's powered by a 400 horsepower engine, making it without doubt one of the highest performing aerobatic biplanes in the world today. As Paul pulls vertical, he'll do the point rolls on the vertical up. At the top of the vertical, Paul's going to do one of the world's smallest inside loops. He's going to turn the aircraft into a helicopter. It's about this time. We'll actually see if we can go to Paul in the cockpit.
Here we go. Get a bit of speed. Hit the fence. Take the trip. Here we go. And roll tumbling tail. They're going to roll into the lip. And we're going to go, oh, big run, right up. And you got to pull over here in a second. Here we go. Right out here, we need as much food as we can get. Mix the windsock.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, what do you think of Paul's flying so far? Ladies and gentlemen, I invite you to move forward and get your cameras out as Paul sets up for his photo pass. He's going to put the aircraft down on the deck nice and slow in a nice side slip to give you a beautiful look at this beautiful yellow biplane known as the Wolf Fitzroy. Slow maneuver and having a motorbike do a backflip over the top of him at the same time. Now Paul's going to set up for his landing sequence, so he's going to reposition out there on airshow left. Put the aircraft down on the deck at speeds of over 300 kilometres an hour. At the end of the runway, Paul's going to pull vertical again as he sets up for landing. So on the up, he's washing off his airspeed. At the top of the vertical, he's going to turn around with the double hammerhead maneuver on the downline. You'll hear Paul pull the power and put the aircraft into a big side slip. Now he puts us into a side slip to actually slow the aircraft down. Because the aircraft is not fitted with any flaps, so he puts the side of the aircraft into the airflow, and he actually can't see over the nose very well, so he looks down the side of the aircraft to pick up the runway. So this concludes Paul's solo display today. I hope you enjoyed it. It's brought to you by Aero Refuelers, Bose Aviation, Airplan EFB, and ICOM Australia. Now as Paul taxis back, he'll park his aircraft up, he'll make his way over to his merchandise trailer, so if the kids want to go over and meet him and get a poster off him, he'll be more than happy to talk about his aircraft and get you all motivated into aviation.
Well done, Glenn. Thank you very much for that great commentary, and we'll be seeing you a little bit later in opposition, shall we say, to the boss.